Hi and welcome to this video. In this video, let's see how to install Git on Windows. Installing Git on Windows is as easy as downloading Git and following the installation steps. Go to your favorite browser and search for Git. I will click on download. I want it for Windows, so I'm going to click on download for Windows. I want to install Git, but you can also use the portable version. I'm just going to click there on 64-bit to download that. We'll just wait for the download to complete, and then I'm going to install it. Open the download folder, and then double-click on Git, double-click. Next, choose the location for installation, next, and then you can select the components that you want to install. So you can click through and see what will be installed. We see we're going to get Git Bash. You can also check for updates if you want updates to occur automatically. You can check for updates. You can add, I will click on that, add Git Bash profile to Windows Terminal. You can leave it at the default settings. And then just click next. Click next. Which editor would you like to use? I will select Visual Studio Code. If there's an editor that you want to use, just try to install it in advance before installing Git. So I will choose Visual Studio Code as Git's default editor. And then I will go next. Let Git decide. You can choose to override the branches, but just let Git decide and then go next. So you can use Git from the command line, which is Bash, or you can also use from third-party software. Or you can use it just with Git Bash only. I'm going to leave it at default because that's the recommended option. And then I'm going to go next. Of course, for this, you can use the bundled OpenSSH version. Go next. For this, I'm just going to go with the default. Of course, I want to use Minty. I'm going to use Minty because it gives me that Linux environment terminal. I will go next. Default, I will leave that at default. Leave that at default. And then I will click on install to finally install Git. So once it's installed, it's going to come with Git Bash, Git GUI, and Git itself. And we're going to see some of this. So you can see the installation is complete. You can view the release notes. I'm not going to. And I'm just going to click finish. So when we come here, you'll see that it comes with Git CMD, Git GUI, and Git Bash. Now, let's first of all go to Git Bash. If you're on Windows and you want to use the terminal with a Linux environment, maybe you're working on a remote Linux system, you can use Git Bash to set up your server. So instead of using PuTTY, just use Git Bash. You can do anything here that you do on a Linux terminal. So maybe you want to SSH into your server, you can just SSH into whichever server it is, root at whatever IP, and you can log in like this. And this is something you normally do on Linux. So you can work with Git Bash instead of using PuTTY if you want that Linux terminal environment. So that's Git Bash. Let's look at the other one, Git GUI. You want to create a repository. You can create a repository, clone, open existing. And if you have other repositories, I believe they will be shown here and you can work with them. And then Git CMD, if you want to work with Git CMD, you can do that here. Git pull, Git push, all that you can do here. So of course, if you're going to work with GitHub, you have to set up SSH authentication for your GitHub on your Windows. All right, so in this video, you've seen how you can install Git on Windows, and you've seen some of the tools that it comes with. Git Bash, Git GUI, and Git CMD. That's it for this video. If you have a question, let me know.